everyone, and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is Francesco here. Today's video, we are looking at Todoist Wishlist 2019. I wanted to share a few of the things that I would like to see next year, and I wanted to also collate or bring together some of the ones that you guys have put out there. I tweeted out last week, I believe it was, and you guys have sent some awesome recommendations for what you'd like to see in Todoist. So hopefully this video gives you a bit of an indication of what could be next year. Naturally, these are all suggestions and things that the Todoist team can definitely pick up on. We'll also be talking about the potentiality of some of these features being brought out. Anyway, guys, I'm really looking forward to today's video, so let's jump in. So guys, just before we begin, make sure to sign up and get a free ticket to ProdCon. This is a virtual conference that we're running at the end of January, January 25th, I think it is, that you can sign up to. It'd be amazing to have you there. We're going to have some amazing speakers as well, and it's all dedicated to understanding and supercharging your time management in 2019. So guys, let's jump in to some of my recommendations first, some of my wish list. I wanted to talk about them. Now, the first one, I'm looking at it and going, actually, it's not possible because they've just announced that Kanban boards are coming very soon. Now, my actual option and recommendation was actually to have a boards view that is optional, so you can actually change any of your projects into board view or today view. And they have announced this. You can watch the video on that in the cards below. I'm really sorry because I actually had my list ready and I probably would have bulked my list out, but naturally they beat me to it by announcing this. Now, next up is calendar week view for me. I would absolutely adore the ability to see a calendar view inside of Todoist. Now, I'm not someone that likes month view. I know many of you guys like month view views, but I personally would love to see a week view or some form of agenda view. So we're sort of seeing this already with task managers that blend calendar experiences. We're seeing this in apps like Sensama and also apps like Method, which we've reviewed here on the channel. And naturally, I would love to see something like this inside of Todoist. Now, it would be cool if you were able to potentially open up your today view in an agenda view and actually block out time dedicated to some stuff. Naturally, you have the Google Calendar two-way integration inside of Todoist, but I would really and deadly love to see the agenda view available inside of Todoist. And I think it would naturally be a great add-on experience. Number two on my list is the card dashboard. I would honestly love to see the ability to click inside of a task and actually get card-like functions. I'd like subtasks to be a bit easier to manage inside of the card. Not necessarily as a drop down menu, which they have now, something where I can go in and actually manage subtasks or potential checklists, a bit like Trello does with its card abilities. Now, I would also love to see some form of notes area inside of that card ability, but again, this probably will roll out with the board's experience, and depending on how it's laid out, could potentially be a killer feature inside of Todoist. Now, I did say better project view in my list, but I can imagine it's going to be changed a lot with board view, but I would really love to see things three style headers. I know at the moment headers are an experience that you can actually create using two exclamation marks and a colon if you wanted a bold header, but at the moment it seems a bit clunky to do that. So I'd love to see headers being able to be added inside of projects. I would also love to see custom fields being added, but then I would wait to see how boards roll out because custom fields can get complicated. So guys, I have some of your replies. A lot of you replied on Twitter to that tweet. 33 replies we have. I picked out a few of the things that I would personally like to see, and also things that got top votes too. So Jason put he would love to see a calendar integration. I definitely think a calendar integration is possible next year, but I would put it on sort of a medium scale. I think they would get boards out of the way first. Scott would like to see project and section headers and also descriptions. Now, I definitely think descriptions should be added to the projects area, and I do think they'll improve headers, so I can imagine they'll probably do this in sort of Q1 period. Now, Mike put snooze tasks to hide them. Now, this is something I adore, absolutely love inside of Swipes, which is an application, a task manager, that allows you to snooze your task, and it completely disappears and goes into a snooze section, and it won't appear again until that time that you do them. I'd love to see something like this. There are tasks on my list where I'm like, sometimes like, I just want to see the task in front of me and have that one appear later on. Maybe like a shopping list of when I arrive in a certain location, or like just generally, like if I'm at time, like 3 o'clock, I want to see that shopping list there. And I don't necessarily need it on my to-do list because it's just going to bug me there. Very small detail. Alex said he would love to see start dates inside of tasks as well. So naturally you have a due date or deadline day, but he would like to see a start date for that as well. I can imagine that's going to be incredibly valuable for projects area. Don't think that they flagged it up, but I don't think it's necessarily going to be top of their list. Luck would like to see drag and drop labels. This is something that I know a lot of people would like to see. I think it would be cool to be able to just drag a label onto the screen and actually be able to attach it to it. I mean, make the experience a lot faster. And it's definitely something that they could probably fix in a small fix. I mean, I'm talking from a non-developer standpoint here, but that would be great to see. Ugo mentions automatic colors. It would be great to see some automatic colors, actually being able to associate automatically a color to each of the projects. That would be quite cool. And also I would like to see the option to customize your prioritization area. That's just something from me. Again, and they have a colorblind mode coming soon so that you can have a blue one instead. But naturally, I would like to see, for example, color themes for your prioritization. Very small addition, but something that would be very cool. Now, Eric put custom sounds when ticking off. Now, I didn't actually think of this as much recently, but then I've been using a few apps. I remember a couple of years ago, I used an app called Proud, which had such beautiful sound animation that when you ticked off a task, it just sounded so great. And it's something that I definitely think Todoist could put a bit of time into, whether it's 2 or 3 sounds that they add or 10, whatever it is, it would be cool to have a tick off sound. But again, it's a very small thing and it's naturally something that is very subjective. But good one, Eric, for shouting that out. Now, Robert has mentioned an Outlook for Mac integration with Todoist. Definitely agree with that. David also echoes that. He would like to see a two-way Office 365 calendar integration with it. I would definitely like to see it. I can imagine they're working on it in the background. Seeing as Alex, their designer, really loves the Outlook design team, I think that's definitely probably something they're going to work on. And finally, Keegan mentions a superhuman integration, which I do not think will be on the horizon in the next couple of months, but I think superhuman, based on when they launched and their price, I think they'll definitely have a Todoist integration. We had one with Newton. I don't think it'll be too hard to integrate, so definitely keep an eye on that, Keegan. So guys, that is the wish list. Thank you very much to everyone on Twitter who recommended theirs. If you want to follow Keep Productive on Twitter, follow at Keep Productive or myself, Francesco D_ALES, and you can fire any questions or any wish lists in the future, and we'll definitely have that. Anyway, guys, if you like Notion too, we've got one of these coming out as well, so stay tuned, or whether the Notion one will be out before the Todoist one, let us see. But guys, a huge thank you for stopping by today. Make sure to have a great week. If you are brand new here, do slam the subscribe button and also hit the like button as well. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for stopping by. I will see you guys in a future video. Cheers.